All right, guys, I've had to move inside because it's getting really cold outside. The temperature since yesterday has dropped drastically, and we're expecting snow sometime before this weekend. But I was freezing out there. But I want to talk to you a minute about the food grade items. Where can you find them? If you go to delis, restaurants, grocery stores, often they have these 5-gallon buckets, and they are food grade buckets. Many of them will just give them away. Some of them will sell them for very, very low prices. I spoke with someone not long ago over the internet that they buy them for like 50 cents a piece. Beats the living tar out of $3 to $5 down at Lowe's. But if you take the initiative and go talk to these people, you could find an almost endless supply of 5-gallon food grade buckets. Now, with these buckets, you can stack these things up to make towers. And then around the sides, now instead of just planting in the top of one bucket, build you a tower, and then like I showed you with the big green barrel out there, you can cut around the sides and have several different places to plant. You could get, you know, at least 4 plants of some kind or another. I saw one video where somebody had done that. They had put like 5 slits around there, and then they had strawberries growing in them and in the top, but that was just in a bucket. Now, if you're in a place like an apartment with a balcony, you could stack these things up. Now, one thing I might suggest also with this is that when you stack these things up, put something down the center, a big pole, to help tie them together so that they don't just fall over. But that's just a little hint there. I'm going to talk to you right now about something. I don't have this built, but I do have a diagram. I have mentioned before on about stair-stepped shelves, and I have this diagram here. Let's see if I can show it to you. I'll bring it up to you here in just a minute. But with a stair-stepped shelf, you can get more rows in a square foot area by going up. Now, the reason for this is that, you know, I did mention in other videos that it's not necessary to plant them exactly as far apart, most plants anyway, exactly as far apart as they're telling you to. You can bring them closer, but on the other hand, you can't just pack them in either, and that is primarily because if you pack them in together, that as they grow, the stems and branches will actually hinder the growth of each other. So if you stair step the things, that gives room for the branches to grow. Now let me bring this up, see if I can get this in, and I'll point this out. Here we go. Now, if you see here, I've got these shelves here. Please forgive my artwork. I'm not an artist. I can do balloons, but I can't do drawing. But if you notice, I've got all these different shelves and then the plants with these things growing up. Now, by doing this, by having them one under another, you get big bushy plants like this. And that gives a little bit more room to grow underneath this one and grow out. This one right here grows a little bit over this one and grows under and just keeps going. And it gives you more room for bushy plants to grow. Now, something else that could be done is the shelf itself could be angled a little bit. But if you do angle it a little bit, make sure that you build a little lip there so that the pots don't slide off. And what that will end up doing is aiming the plant to grow outward rather than straight up, and will actually give you a little bit more room. Now there are other types of plants, so you got to think about what kind of plants you're growing. Some plants, lower growing, grow more straight up. You know, what you might want to consider there really is just a straight up shelf where all the shelves come up underneath each other, and it could be fine. This is primarily for one that is like an intermediate plant and a little bit bushy. An example, maybe broccoli. As a matter of fact, I got some broccoli out here right now. I don't know how it's going to work with the snow possibly coming in early. But think about this. Look at this. This is just this design right here. One actually down on the ground in front of it, and then one, two, three, five, six, seven, eight. This particular design, okay, there's eight right there. But if you laid them side by side on the ground, you probably wouldn't get more than four rows of it. So guys, that's another way that you can do this. Now, to come up to the point that I am quite sure a lot of people don't like. This is the point where I just talked to you about, you know, your mentality to get you to think. When I was a kid, my father used to give me tasks to do, either on the farm or around the house, in the shop, or on the construction site, because back then, he could take me out on the construction sites with him. And he would give me a task and say, do this. All the tools are over here. And then he would just leave me to it. And I would spend all day long doing these things. And looking at it, it's like, okay, how would I do it? You know, sometimes I would go to him and ask him, I'm a little bit stuck, what can I do? And he would give me a little bit of a direction. So I would go do this. Then at the end of the day, I'm done. He'd come look at it. And he'd say, that's not bad. Now let's do it right. And then he'd bring out the right tools. And then he would start showing me. By the way, sorry, my daughter's pizza is ready. I got to go in about 5 minutes and get it. But then he would show me this, and it used to aggravate the living crap out of me. I said, Dad, why didn't you just show me this in the first place? And he said, Son, if I showed it to you from the very beginning, you would not have learned how to think. You would not have learned how to look at this problem and analyze it for yourself and to determine a solution. When I was in the Army, I was in for 10 years in the infantry. The first unit I was in, their wartime, real wartime mission was to conduct raids and then to break up into small units and conduct guerrilla operations. And going through the training, one of our instructors asked, what is the most dangerous weapon you have in your possession? Matt, people came up with all kinds of answers, from explosives to the different kinds of weapons and stuff. And the instructor said, you're all wrong. Your brain is your most efficient and dangerous weapon. And it made me think about what my dad did with me. And I was very grateful for what my dad did, because I was one of the few that in that training managed to excel, because I had been taught to think. I had been taught to analyze. Don't accept anything by just what you see. To understand that one situation is not the same as the other, and that you may have to adjust. And this is what I have here. You see, I can't give each and every one of you exact methods and techniques to follow, because each one of you has a different situation. Guys, remember the name of my channel, The Self-Sufficient Life. The beginning of self-sufficiency is to be able to use what you've got up here to think, to look, to analyze. This technique may not work exactly the way he's saying for me, but is there a way I can modify it so that it will work for me well? That's what I'm trying to do here, guys. I'm really trying to help you. I can't give you everything. If I give you one thing for this one person, it might not work for the other one. But with just a little slight modification, it will work for you. But you see, you have to do it. I can't do it for you. I wish I could, because I think things are going to be getting pretty rough sometime soon, before they even get better. And I want you guys to be able to provide for yourselves and your family, especially if you got kids. I want to encourage you guys, take what I'm doing, think about it. And, you know, if you think it won't work for you, think about how it can. Search out YouTube, search out other things, and try to find a way for it to work. Guys, I care about you. I want to see things go well with you. So I'm going to end here. My daughter's coming down from school. Got to get her lunch on the table. So guys, this is The Self-Sufficient Life, signing off. You take care of yourselves.